If you've ever found yourself stuck in a conversation with a stranger and you don't know if it's going well or if it's a disaster and you're not sure how to keep it going or end it, I got some comforting news. It turns out they're thinking the exact same thing. Two studies published in 2018 confirm the fact that everyone dreads casual chats with strangers, and our worst ability is knowing how and when to end them. I'm Justin with Inverse, and I'm here to help. Stick around, hit the like, and subscribe for more helpful science news and tips. Now, before we solve the crisis of how the hell do I end this conversation, let's get into why we all think we're so bad at it in the first place. In a 2018 study out of Cornell about bridging the liking gap, it was found that nearly everyone rates having a conversation with a stranger as one of their least desired activities. A majority of subjects reported feeling underconfident in their ability to engage in casual conversation. And then, after having conversations, when asked about any awkward pauses or missteps that occurred, almost everyone blamed themselves for making it weird and assumed that they liked the company of their partner more than their partner liked talking to them. People just assume they're a lot less likable than they really are. Now, when it comes to ending conversations, it turns out that truly nobody knows how to do it. In a 2018 study conducted at Harvard, researchers found that there was a huge difference in when people wanted to end a conversation and when it actually happened. In the study, researchers put two strangers in a room and told them to have a conversation until they both agreed that the conversation was over. By the end of the study, it was determined that only 15% of people ended the conversation when they really wanted to. The other 85% either found themselves stuck in a conversation that went on too long or ended a lot earlier than they would have liked. This was mainly because, the researchers determined, humans are pretty terrible at knowing what other people want. Now, if you guys have any embarrassing stories of conversations going too long or getting cut off too short, dear God, please share them below in the comments. I would love to read them. And even knowing that none of us know how or when to do it, it doesn't make it any less awkward or painful to cut a conversation short. For those that need a little help, here are some tips from psychology and sociology experts about surefire ways to end a conversation without feeling anxious or guilty. Physical clues. Even if they're subtle, beginning to drop certain physical hints to your conversation partner will subconsciously let them know you're ready to leave. For example, bodily proximity, which is just a fancy way of saying how close you're standing to them. Sociologist Erving Goffman believes that the ideal distance between two people in a conversation is no closer than 1.5 feet and no further than 3 feet. If you incrementally push yourself outside of this 3-foot range, your partner will start to notice a literal and figurative gap and be more likely to wrap things up. Other physical clues include reducing eye contact and turning your body away from the other person. Even if done very subtly, this can indicate to your partner that you're ready for the conversation to end. Tip number 2, language. Obviously, a conversation is just words, words, and more words, but figuring out the right words to imply that the conversation is over is key. Sociologist and author Eric Barker believes that one very easy word choice can do the trick, using the past tense. As soon as you start talking in the past tense, such as, "It was great seeing you," or "This has been fun," it puts both people in the same headspace that the event happened and it's now over. Other examples include goodbyes through implication, which often involve giving the person a task, such as tell your wife I say hi, or make sure to send me a link to that movie you were talking about. Then it makes the goodbye seem productive instead of flat. All right, the final tip, power dynamics. This is a tricky one because it's not always something you can have control over. Social psychology generally dictates that whoever started the conversation generally has more of a priority to end it, especially if they began the conversation with a task or agenda in mind. If the conversation ends without them getting what they needed or wanted, it can feel rude or incomplete, at least for them. Unfortunately, sociologist Keo Stark states that sometimes a perceived power, whether it be real or imagined, can strongly dictate who gets to start and end conversations. And it takes real gusto to overthrow that power hierarchy. If it's your boss, it will always feel strange to tell them, "Hey, I'm done talking to you." But acknowledging the agendas that both people hypothetically started with can help make the inevitable ending seem mutually beneficial. Keep these 3 concepts in mind the next time you find yourself in a conversation that you're not sure how to end. And remember, acknowledging these very human things can also be used to figure out when your partner wants to end the conversation with you. If you notice them putting more distance between you, or talking in the past tense, or trying to control the power, let them end it. It'll make both of you feel better. Probably. In the end, we all think that we're way worse at having conversations than we really are anyway, and nobody knows how to end them, so there's really no pressure. Now remember, if you guys like this video, please like and subscribe to get more science news every week. I'm Justin, I'm officially ending this conversation. What is your go-to move to end a conversation? Comment below, I wanna see all of these answers. It's like the opposite of a pickup line. It's like a drop-off line. Like, how do you end a conversation? Please, comment below, I gotta know.